from years of mining on the reservation during World War II. Older water wells dot the landscape. Sarah Begay, who's lived on the reservation all her life, took us to this one. It's still pumping water, but few dare drink from it anymore.
For years, I mean, maybe a good 20, 30 years.
It was fine.
It was fine.
Mm-hmm.
People started getting sick.
So dig deep must dig deeper. And the clock is ticking.
I'm running out of water by the middle of the night. It's a painful experience.
And most of them do.
So who's to blame for this?
The counties and the states say it's the federal responsibility, and the feds say we're broke, it's the states and the counties' responsibility.
A lot of fingerprinting.
Oh, yes. Yeah. A lot of passing the buck.
And so, the Navajo wait. The next will be building gravity-fed storage tanks like these that could be hooked up to faucets inside. But that's several years and probably countless fundraisers away.
Things are not simple yet. But every time you have even the smallest success in your projects, those little moments are so tremendously happy. I think really starting to live for this project is ours.
Do you think you've ever seen a day where
everyone here?
I just hope so. I just pray.
Darlene, what would you do without her?
I don't know.
Aside from her morning